So they're both types of spinal stimulation, but they work a little bit differently.
And you have a spine here to show us.
I have a spine model to show you. And the main difference between them is two things. The difference of where the spinal stimulation occurs and then for what kind of problem. So for dorsal root ganglion or DRG stimulation, that is, the treatment is done at the level of the nerve, which you see right here coming out of the spine. And so a stimulator wire such as this would be placed right along that nerve, stimulating the nerve itself. And so that's more for specific nerve injuries, for focal pain, or for pain in a small region, like say foot and ankle.
Like what Bob had.
Like what Bob had, exactly. Spinal cord stimulation, on the other hand, is the spinal cord runs through the middle of the spinal canal, and that lead is placed in the middle of the spinal canal, going on up, delivering electrical stimulation to the whole spinal cord. So it can affect more widespread area of pain relief, such as problems in the back that go all the way down the legs.
And how are these implanted? I mean, it seems pretty complicated when you have your model here and how you have to put that, weave that through.
Yep. So this is about an hour and a half procedure. It's outpatient, so patients typically go home the same day. There's two parts, so I tell patients this is a two-part procedure because there's two parts to the device. So there's the stimulating wire, which I showed already, and then there's a battery pack, which is sort of the brains of the operation, and this is where the stimulation is made and it's delivered through the electrical wire or stimulating electrode. So this battery pack typically is implanted through an incision that sits right at the level of the belt line, and the stimulating wire itself is implanted through an incision in the back. So it's two parts, two incisions, about an hour and a half surgery. And the difference between this and other spinal surgery that's important is this is a reversible procedure, so for any reason this needed to come out, it could be removed.